Lacey Sports and Indiana Members Credit Union are proud to present the 2003 Boys State Basketball Championships.
From Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, it is time for the 3A State Championships. Fort Wayne Elmhurst, the Trojans, versus Bishop Chatard, the Trojans, and Dave Nicholson again looking for another great contest. Two teams that haven't ever experienced this level of play before.
What an exciting thing it must be for both the coaches and the team. It's a first in their school's history, as you said, and they're going to go for it, and you know everything's going to be left on the court.
Absolutely. Our matchups, lineups, and the tip-off all coming up next. Stay tuned. The 3A State Championships moments away, lying straight ahead. And we're going to take a look at some of the key players first for Fort Wayne Elmhurst. Dave Nicholson.
Okay, for the Elmhurst Trojans, let's take a look at their key players. James Hardy, number 34, averaging almost 23 points a game and almost 9 rebounds, an outstanding player for Elmhurst. The other key player, Joe Poindexter, number 23, averages 16 points a game, 5 rebounds, excellent free throw shooter at 77%. And the keys to the game for Elmhurst tonight as they go against Chatard, balanced attack. They've got to have more than two people scoring. Work outside in. They go with a perimeter shot, but they've got to get some points down in the paint as well. Juniors have got to step up. They expect the seniors to be there. They've got to have the juniors step up.
All right, let's go to public address announcer Scott Gregg for tonight's lineups and
ladies
more.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin today's competition on the basketball court, we ask you to pause for a moment of tribute to those many men and women who have put themselves in harm's way in order that we might enjoy the freedom we have come to expect and revere. As a nation, we have resolved that terrorists shall not rob us of that freedom. And now that Operation Iraqi Freedom is underway, we are asked to display once again the resolve which we have embraced during previous tumultuous times. In cities and towns across Indiana, high school sporting events generate pride and bring our people together in a united and spirited manner. We compete against one another as teams and communities, but stand unified in one cause as Americans. Let us pause for a moment of reflection. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Indianapolis and Conseco Fieldhouse for the 93rd Annual Indiana High School Athletic Association Boys Basketball State Finals. Our game this evening for the Class 3A State Championship featuring the Fort Wayne Elmhurst Trojans and the Indianapolis Bishop Chatard Trojans. Here are your rosters and starting lineups for tonight's championship game. First for Fort Wayne Elmhurst. Number 4, David Love. Number 5, Derek Smith. Number 22, John Locke. 24, Alan Tatum. 30, Steve Driver. 32, Charles Pearson. 50, Brandon Stuckey. And the starting lineup for the Trojans of Fort Wayne Elmhurst. At one forward, a 6'2" senior, number 23, Joe Poindexter. At the other forward slot, a 6'7" junior, number 34, James Hardy. At center, a 6'3" senior, number 42, Ben Stifler. At guard, a 6-foot senior, number 20, Britton Flowers. At guard, a 6'1" junior, number 33, Chad Edmonds. And the head coach of the Fort Wayne Elmhurst Trojans, Keith Edmonds. And now your roster and starting lineup for the Bishop Chatard Trojans. Number 14, John Lockery. 22, Dre Mason. 34, Frank Halliburton. Number 42, Greg Cage. Number 50, Tony Barnes. Number 53, Jimmy Scheidler. Number 55, Jonas Coleman. And the starting lineup for the Trojans of Bishop Chatard. At forward, a 6'5" senior, number 33, Mike Dury. At forward, a 6'5" senior, number 44, Dan Cage. The center, a 6'5" junior, number 24, Ryan Baker. At guard, a 6-foot senior, number 20, Jamal Wade. And at guard, a 5'9" senior, number 23, Marcus Presley. Head coach of the Bishop Chatard Trojans, Dan Archer.
Motorcycles of Indianapolis revving us up for tonight's starting lineups, the 3A state finals. And our keys. Go ahead, David.
Okay, let's take a look at the keys for Bishop Chatard. The key players for the Trojans coming in here, 21-2. Jamal Wade, number 20, average 11 points, shoots 46% from the field. And their big scorer, Dan Cage, number 44, averages 19 points a game, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists for the Trojans. Keys to the game for Chatard, leadership. They should have plenty of that because they are a veteran ball club. Work the boards. They're the most physical team, perhaps, in this entire tournament. And they must get to the free throw line.
All right. Those are our keys to win, our key players. The stage is set. And some physical activity, I think, lying straight ahead, Dave.
Well, as I mentioned, Chatard plays a very physical basketball game. I think that's going to be a real key for Elmhurst, is to bang with them on the boards.
And the tip is controlled by Chatard. Just 15 miles away from Conseco Fieldhouse. This is like playing at home for them.
Well, Chatard's been building for 3 years with this same group of kids. This was their goal, to get to the championship game and have a state chance to win the state, and they've accomplished that. You can have goals, but you've got to work very hard to get there no matter what your talent is. So our congratulations to Coach Dan Archer and his ball club.
Coming across the lane is Baker. Ryan Baker, the first to score tonight. Baker, 6'5" junior, averages close to 9 a game. And Dan Archer's Tar Trojans on the board, leading early. Now the long three attempt, a little bit long for Harvey. We'll keep our eye on him. He's a good one. Another pull-up jump shot off the rim for Edmonds. And here comes Chatard.
The book on Elmhurst is they're a freewheeling ball club, up and down the court, shoot a lot of threes, a fast-paced team.
And Flowers, the steal, the lay-in attempt, a little too strong. But boy, you can tell they're quick.
Craig, you may see a little bit of jitters and nerves here in the first 2 or 3 minutes by both teams. That's normal. You're playing for a state championship. It's not just another game, no matter what anybody says.
It is not just another game. You're exactly right. And two excellent coaches out here, Keith Edmonds being one of them, Fort Wayne Elmhurst.
Just got a good look at Keith there on your screen. He is 22-5 with this ball club, and he said one of the highlights was getting this team this far in the tournament.
Cage hammered as he goes to the hoop. And Dan Cage is one we'll keep a close watch on here tonight. Outstanding player, as we mentioned in our pregame. And there's a shot across the way of head coach Dan Archer.
Dan Cage, there at your line, is already signed with St. Bonaventure, so he's going to be playing at the next level next year.
Well, you see a lot of Division I players coming out of this contest. Cage, as you mentioned, Dave, one of them. Free throw is good.
If you were running a collegiate program and you spent today in Indianapolis and you could get all the kids that you wanted that played here in the four games, you'd be set pretty well on your roster.
And you know what I'm liking is, you know, Cage an exception, but certainly a lot of these good players are staying here in Indiana. Seeing more and more of that, aren't we? Elmhurst with a breakaway.
You are seeing more of that, and as you say, that's very good to see that. You like to see Hoosier kids stay in the state and play for Indiana School.
Flowers with two on one end. Dury misses on the long range shot. Here comes Elmhurst on the transition. Oh, beautiful job. Outstanding.
Well, that was Chad Edmonds, the coach's son, that made that pass, and what a great assist it was, hitting Flowers going down the middle.
Flowers with two more, he has four. We're tied at four. Great recognition down low again. Bishop Chatard looking for Dan Cage, and for good reason. He's awfully strong down low.
Now, I'm not sure officially if they do this, but I have always felt when you make that kind of pass that Ryan Baker just made to Dan Cage, if he makes his first free throw, I've always thought you should get an assist, because it was a perfect pass and it enabled Cage to get to the free throw line.
You are kind of robbed, aren't you, from the assist?
Absolutely, because it's a great pass.
Cage with the free throw following.
Here comes your replay, and you just saw Ryan Baker made that pass over to Dan Cage and put him in perfect position to either get a layup or get to the line.
Cage outstanding all season long from the free throw line, an 81% free throw shooter. Now with 4 points. And Chatard up by a couple.
Here comes a half court 1-3-1 trap by Chatard, and Dan Archer, the coach of Chatard, said he was going to switch defenses, and he comes right out and puts a half court press on. You see the coach over on the Elmhurst bench holding up Trojans, so they got some play. That's not just a nickname. He wants a set play.
Elmhurst without the services, at least right now, of Steve Driver, a pinched nerve in his shoulder. He tried to play in the sectionals, but it flared up. May be available here tonight. We'll have to wait and see. Cutting to the basket, and the foul as Poindexter makes his move to the hole.
Fouls on Ryan Baker, his first. Steve, you mentioned Steve Driver from Elmhurst. He has been such a key part of this team. He averages 11 points a game. And word was he may try to go some tonight. We'll see. But they have done a great job with him being injured to play on and to get here.
A little difficult with a pinched nerve being in that area to play in a game like this at this level. Elmhurst to inbound and out of bounds.
Good defense there, but Chatard forced the turnover. And Elmhurst, of course, as you can see on your screen, is picking up in a full court tight pressure as well. It's a man-to-man. Stand corrected. It's a 1-2-2. They jumped into a 1-2-2, which means there should be a double team on the ball.
Wade, a nice job as he brings the ball up. Inside, Dury, nice pass there. And a foul as Jamel Wade does a nice job suspending himself in the air to draw the foul. Wade averaging 11 points per game. And Wade will shoot a couple of free throws.
Number 34, James Harding.
The foul was on James Harding, number 34, his first. You've already got a pretty good view of what the philosophy is for Chatard. They have taken that ball down inside almost every time, and we talked about how strong they are. Most of these kids were on the state football championship team. And they just like to get down in there and mix it up down low.
Wade, a 72% free throw shooter, makes one, misses one. Yeah, you're right. Chatard, outstanding football team, and
Boy, when you got athletes, you got athletes, and they can play any sport. And Coach Edmonds knows all about that, talking about his Elmhurst focus. Here's Coach Edmonds.
Well, I mean, once we get past these types of things, you know, getting past the media and those types of things, we just want to make sure that kids understand that there's still a game to be played. And again, our kids have kept their focus. Our celebrations through the sectional and the regional arena in our state, we're very subdued. Our kids have just they understood that, that it's nice to win, but they want to win the ultimate.
Well, Elmhurst had not won a sectional game in 5 years prior to Edmonds coming on board. So what an accomplishment, what a great team this program has had here this season.
While we were watching that bit on the coach, Jamar Wade took a three-pointer in the corner, did not make it, but there's Mike Drury, another one of the 6'5 players, crashing the boards, and he got fouled and is at the free throw line. Going to see that on a replay. There's a shot up by Wade in the corner, and you saw Mike Drury, he happened to be the quarterback on the football team, by the way, pull it down with two hands, powered up, and he missed his first, but he'll get another one.
Dury misses on the free throw. Multi-talented athlete. You mentioned the quarterback, also excellent baseball pitcher playing in Notre Dame. The other way we go. Cage is too strong on the lay-in attempt. Baker puts it back. Ryan Baker with a two-point field goal.
Last time down, you saw Chad Edmonds go down to the 10-second line. He's still kind of gimpy as he goes down. We'll see how that plays out.
A jump ball. Possession arrow favoring Elmhurst.
The Chatard's defense to this point has been more tenacious than has Elmhurst. It's forced a couple of turnovers and a 5-second count. And now we've got a timeout called by Elmhurst.
Both teams going to talk things over during the break. Chatard in early lead, up by 5, 9-4 right now in the 3A state finals. And we'll keep it right here and remind you that, well, actually ask a question. We'll remind you by asking a question. Do you own a Hewlett Packard or a Lexmark printer? Or how about a color printer from Okadata? For whatever printer you do own, you know about Canon 4. When it comes to printers, printer service, and computer supplies, Canon 4 has the solution. Canon 4, your printer service, and computer supply source. Canon 4 serving Fort Wayne and Central Indiana. Visit them at www.canon4.com.
Mentioned that Chad Edmonds had gone to the floor. And he's moving very well right now and seems to have shaken off any ill effects of that crash a minute ago.
Trojans from Elmhurst back with the basketball. Trailing by 5 and a foul out top. You don't like to see it that far out, do you?
Dan Cage got a little over aggressive, didn't move his feet. The offensive player pushed off, but the push off came after the blocking foul, so it was a good call.
Third team foul.
Need to get James Hardy, number 34, involved in this offense.
Wonderful steal. Chatard, things getting a little bit ragged.
Well, that's going to be on James Hardy, Craig, and that's his second personal. And the key about that is he's a big-time scorer for Elmhurst, 23 points a game, and he has two quick fouls.
That could change the tempo right there, couldn't it?
It's going to change the scoring ability of the Trojans.
Chatard to inbound beneath the basket. Cage looking for an open man, finally finds Wade, who pops out for it. Good rotation and a steal attempt. Loose on the floor. Elmhurst fighting for it. It's still loose and back into the hands of the Trojans. And out of bounds.
Just nice hustle by both ball clubs. You had two or three guys on the floor scrambling for the ball. Elmhurst came up with it, and you saw Hardy make a real good choice. He knows he's playing with two fouls. He could have gone all the way, but he might have gotten the charge. So anyway, he came, he made a good decision, pulled up and dropped it off. I've got to be careful saying Trojans because both of these teams' mascots are the Trojans, so I better refer to them by the name of the school.
Yeah, but as Dennis Casey says, we're always right.
Well, we're always Trojans. Right. Craig, we're always right anyway, but in this case, we can't be wrong.
I don't know about that.
Oh, yeah.
Chatard, strong inside game continues. Ryan Baker with two more. And Baker averaging close to 9, already has 6.
Well, I think they're paying a lot of attention to Dan Cage, and now Ryan Baker's stepping up. Another guy that can step up is Wade, number 20.
And Flowers fouled out top. A foul on Britton Flowers. And I believe we might have a timeout. Boy, what a wonderful pregame we had with Kathleen Horgan singing God Bless America and our national anthem. It's been a great day here in Indianapolis. We'll be back with more. A timeout on the floor from Conseco Fieldhouse. Trojans from Chatard on top by seven.
Like one key player from each ball club got a little bit of foul trouble. Dan Cage from Chatard with two. And of course, we mentioned James Hardy with two for Elmhurst. We'll see how that plays out.
All righty, Presley with a nice job inside as he gets the ball to Barnes, who's in the ball game. Stuckey with the field goal. Brandon Stuckey with the 2 points. And it is out of bounds, and it belongs to Fort Wayne. Elmhurst with the ball.
Elmhurst has not been able to get to the free throw line, whereas Chatard has already attempted eight and made five. So they're doing a good job attacking the basket.
Pull-up jump shot by Hardy is good. And you knew that would happen sooner or later. Hardy averaging close to 23, as you mentioned, Dave. His first points.
He's got to get going and give his ball club a lift. That may do it.
Absolutely. Bob Nagel will join us a little bit later on here in the first half with our sideline reports.
With all that inside play Chatard's getting, Elmhurst has decided to drop into a 2-3 zone, and the purpose of that is to sag the middle, make Chatard go from the outside.
Chatard,
young man right there with the ball, Jamal Wade, is a 38% three-point shooter.
Dury inside, and his first field goal.
In spite of the zone, Dury was able to find a crease and get down the lane and score the layup.
His first field goal, averaging 10.3 per game. Knifing move to the basket, and Edmonds draws the foul.
What a great quick first step Chad Edmonds demonstrated there and got to the hoop before anyone could do anything about it, and he benefits by getting two free throws.
Well, he is a good one, as we, I think, mentioned earlier, the son of head coach Keith Edmonds.
And he wanted everybody to know that he is 6'2.5". He's growing this year. He's no longer 6'1". His dad made that clear at the press conference the other day.
Well, that's a good clarification.
You know, it's a great privilege. It also brings some special pressure coaching your own son. I had the privilege of doing that with my son in high school. But it really is a great opportunity to spend some quality time. As I say, it brings a little additional pressure because there's always those people who feel like maybe your son plays when he shouldn't. What I've found, most coaches probably are a little tougher on their son than they are the other kids on the team.
Yeah, I can appreciate that. I think you're right. Cross court, left-handed shot. Dury sinks it. Dury with 5 points. Got a nice touch from out there.
There's that defensive pressure by Chatard again.
And Chatard comes up with a loose ball. Oh, applying some extra pressure, and it pays off.
I'm not sure Chatard's quicker, but they're definitely physically stronger, and I think that's showing up. They're winning most of the battles for loose balls on the floor. They're not afraid to go right at people.
Inside, Baker, no. Loose along the baseline and out of bounds. Dan Archer credits his seniors for Chatard's success.
And when these kids were young, they kept asking me, what could they do? What could they do to get us to win? And one of the things I talked about was just where we are right now. Let us coach and get everybody together. And they've done a great job of leading us, both on and off the court. There's times where they're a little harder on the players sometimes than we are. In practice, we go hard in the drills, and you can't say enough about it. I mean, the excellence of the football program is obviously well known, and I think it's carrying over into basketball.
Ryan Baker with that 2-point field goal. He has eight. A little bit short on a long range shot by Hardy. Elmhurst, though, fighting for the loose ball, and a nice effort by Flowers to try to get it back.
Well, Jamal Wade just got a little bit careless there with the basketball, and he caused that turnover by not putting a value on taking care of it. Ryan Baker, of course, is only a junior, and everyone's talking about him being a Mr. Football candidate in the state of Indiana for next year.
Substitutions for both teams, I believe, at this point. 47.6 left to go in the first period.
We've got Jonas Coleman coming in, number 55 for Chatard. You got Craig Cage, that's a younger brother of Dan Cage, number 42 in the ballgame.
John Locke is in for Elmhurst, and Locke triggers it in on the missed shot. Bishop Chatard has it back.
Coleman has started for the Chatard ball clubs earlier in this season. They play a lot of people.
Earlier, Lafayette Central Catholic, a winner over Southwestern. And Cass, a 57-48 winner over Forest Park. In our 1 and 2A games.
We'll see the last shot taken by Chatard.
8 seconds. Cage, the leaner, nope, the tip attempt, no good. Another tip try, too late. And Chatard continues to hammer the boards. A very physical first period. And we'll take a break. Be back in a moment. Chatard has doubled up Elmhurst. You're watching the 3A championships from Conseco Fieldhouse. Bob Nagel, Robert, how you doing?
Well, we're up here in the stands again, Craig, with a chance to talk to some of the family members. Coach Archer's got his team off to a good start, and that's got to make his wife Susan feel pretty good.
Very excited. We're really glad to be here, and it's been fun all week, and we just hope the boys can pull it out.
Coach is pretty excited about this group of seniors on the team.
Yes, they're very special young men. They're like sons to us, and they're very neat to us.
And you got the rest of your team here with you. Courtney, what do you think about Dad tonight?
I think he's done really well.
And how about you?
I really like it, and they're really good people, and I feel like I have 12 brothers.
That's a great way to look at it. Congratulations. Good luck tonight. Craig?
All right, Bob. Great job down there. Jonas Coleman we saw on the other end with a two-point field goal, and now it's Chatard with a ball back. And, Dave, you know, we were obviously told ahead of time to look for the deep bench for Chatard, and we're seeing it already, aren't we?
Absolutely. As you see, also we said to watch for Dan Cage, and we're seeing him. In that first quarter, Chatard won the rebound battle 10-5, and they were on a current 9-2 run at this point.
22-9. Chatard on top. Elmhurst trying to fight their way back in, and that's one way of doing it, isn't it? Driver, pinched nerve and all.
That's the young man we talked about that was going to try to play tonight. That's normally a starter, averages 11 points a game. If he can go, Craig, he'll make a real difference in Elmhurst, particularly on the offensive end of the court.
He looked pretty good on that shot. No evidence of a problem with his shoulder. Almost a turnover, and now it is. Elmhurst gets it back. This is Presley. Wow, what an athletic move by Marcus Presley. Presley. Poindexter, rather, with the 2 points. His first.
Joe Poindexter, as you said, demonstrated great athletic ability.
And the three is good by Dan Cage.
Most people make the move that Poindexter made last time. He'd have to go to the chiropractor and get straightened out. He scored the basket.
25-13, Chatard. And Poindexter denied. Again, the strength of Chatard inside. They're not going to let a lot of things happen down there low.
They're going to have to hit some perimeter shots and spread their defense out, because if you try to take it inside, there's 1, 2, or 3, 6, 5 guys waiting on you, and they're going to send the ball back in.
Flowers with a nice tip. Elmhurst has it back. And again, a three attempt off the mark. The rebound, though, into the hands of Hardy. Hardy gets it back. His jump shot rims. And Chatard comes up with it. Cage, Greg Cage with the rebound.
James Hardy's having a tough time getting going offensively. He has one field goal, but he's going to have to get going offensively if Elmhurst is going to get back even in this ballgame.
The three attempt hits the front rim. And a foul beneath the basket. And that'll be on Cage.
It'll be on the young Cage, I think, isn't it? Greg, the sophomore.
looks a lot like his brother, and he's going to be maybe even bigger and stronger because he's only a sophomore.
6'4" sophomore, Greg Gage.
I mentioned Hardy, James Hardy, 34 for Elmhurst, got to get going. He's only 1-for-5, and he's 0-for-4 from the three-point line.
TGI Fridays downtown, located at 501 West Washington Street across from Victory Field. TGI Fridays serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week, starting at 6 a.m. Free throw doesn't go in.
That was by Hardy. He's a 73%er, so we saw earlier in the day, though, Craig, a good score, one or two baskets can really get them jump started. So you hope for James Hardy that he gets going here for his ball club.
Substitution for Elmhurst. Looks like Locke will take a seat. Chatard up by 12. Inside 5 minutes to play in the first half. I didn't quite see that.
That's a quick inbounds play. Hardy tucked the ball in, and the most dangerous guy is probably the guy that tosses it in because the defense loses him. Hardy stepped on court, tucked a quick dribble, and caught the defense flat-footed and drew the blocking foul. That's the eighth team foul on Chatard, so obviously Elmhurst will be in the bonus the rest of the half. Elmhurst only has 5 team fouls.
And Hardy to the free throw line. We've talked a lot about Hardy here tonight. Very good free throw shooter, 73% in the season.
Just missed one up there a second ago, and he needs to get his rhythm, and even a couple of free throws can get him going offensively.
Elmhurst, a 66% free throw shooting team. Well, and he's struggling a little bit.
Poor shooting continues for their best shooter.
So the lead remains Chatard's up by 12. Mason off to the left side. Cage will bring it out top. Dan Cage. Looks inside, nothing there. Presley. Mason. And Chatard, very deliberate right now.
Seeing Mike Dury working inside the low post, and he'll rotate out to the wing. They've got several players that are very versatile. Of course, Dan Cage can go inside, outside. Dury can go inside, outside. So they can change up a little bit on it.
Dan Cage across the lane, can't get it to drop. Couple attempts, and finally the second is good for Coleman.
What an individual effort that was for join us, Coleman.
Coleman with 4 points, and what a great effort there on the putback by Edmonds. Chad Edmonds with his first field goal. Edmonds with 3. And the whistle here and a timeout coming up. Boy, that rebound advantage right now, big for Chatard. They've doubled up Fort Wayne Elmhurst, 16-8. Back in a moment, the 3A state championships from Indianapolis. Fan support here tonight at Conseco Fieldhouse, and a look at our Methodist Sports Medicine scoreboard showing the Trojans and the Trojans. And Chatard right now leading the Trojans of Elmhurst. In some numbers, Dave.
Let's take a look at the shooting, and you'll see why there's a 12-point margin in favor of Chatard. They're 10 of 20 from the field, 50%. 4 of 7 here in the second quarter. Fort Wayne Elmhurst, 7 of 19 for only 37%.
Very interesting. Mason. Chatard coming in 21-2. Inside, the move to the basket. Dury, 2 more points.
Good patience, and they're getting the shots they want, and they're finishing. Rebounding such a key thing. Both Cage brothers have three rebounds. Excuse me. Drury has 3 and Coleman 3. So everybody's hitting the bank boards for the Chatard Trojans.
They're getting those high percentage shots as well. Stuckey fouled as he went to the basket. So Brandon Stuckey will step to the free throw line for head coach Keith Edmonds. We talked earlier about the job he has done. Just a remarkable job. Prior to his coming to the school, they hadn't won a sectional in 5 years. And, you know, it starts with a head coach and that leadership. Very important.
Here's a replay, and you're going to see the bounce, the pass into Stuckey. And there Jonas comes over. Jonas Coleman, number 55, and White comes over, leaves his feet, which is not a good idea. You want to go straight up if you do not get into the shooter. It didn't hurt him offensively because Stuckey was not able to hit either free throw.
Yeah, and Stuckey 66% on the season. Couple of misses. That three attempt, woefully short.
Guess what you're going to hear now?
Yeah, Presley does hear it.
They call air ball. Wonder why they don't call rim when you hit the rim. rim, you know.
It's not as fun. Elmhurst gets it back. And they need a little momentum here going into the locker room at halftime.
Tell you what, I think if a kid's good enough to be on playing for a state championship, I doubt if the chant of air ball is going to bother him.
Yeah, it doesn't bother those types, does it? Hardy with a great job along the baseline. And nice block attempt by Stuckey, but apparently the foul on Stuckey. Looked like a pretty good defensive play, and Edmonds thought so too.
You're going to see Dan Cage, an 81% shooter at the line. He's already made four free throws in this ball game, all in the first quarter, so he's off to a great start. He has 9 points, or I have him for nine at least, in this ball game.
Dan Cage can't get that free throw to drop.
You know, one thing in Elmhurst's favor, one more foul on Chatard and they have the double bonus. We've got 2 minutes and 44 seconds to go to halftime. If you recall earlier today in the Southwestern game, Central Catholic was way behind, but they got back in the ball game. A lot of it had to do with the free throw line.
Jump shot, Hardy. Wow, what a weapon.
Great vertical lift, and he's off the mark now. That's his seventh point. It took him a while to get going.
A 10-point ball game. A little bit out of control is Cage. The rebound putback attempt, good. Well, Cage on the miss, but a wonderful follow by Coleman.
I didn't think Coleman had room to get that thing up, but he twisted his body. He's kind of underneath the backboard, leaned back in, and finished it with a soft tap.
And a long three by Poindexter. Joe Poindexter with a triple. And the tempo picking up here on both sides. Inside 2 minutes to play in the first half.
Elmhurst got this into a single digit lead.
Oh, what a wonderful entry pass. Dury with two more.
What do you do when you need a basket? You go back to your strength, which is your inside play. They post up the strong guys and answer.
Poindexter on the long miss. Cage, oh, what a wonderful job there, huh? Cage, two more points.
Good individual effort there. Did the 360 and put it off the glass.
And we have seen some great individual effort here tonight. Excellent pass and a foul. Poindexter right on the money with his pass.
That was a great job of Brandon Stuckey of sealing off his defender and catching the ball and then positioning his body to ward off the defender, and the defender really had no choice. You either give him a layup or you foul him, and they put Stuckey to free throw line.
Methodist Sports Medicine Center, in partnership with Clarion Health, treats athletes and active people throughout Indiana and is the official sports medicine provider of the IHSAA and its state championship events. Visit four Indianapolis area locations as we take a look at the replay here, including a new location in Avon. Call 1-800-SPORTS-MED or visit the web at methodistsports.com. Sports, work, life, we keep you in the game. And a couple of free throws by Stuckey, keeping this Fort Wayne Elmhurst team in the game a bit. An 11-point lead for Chatard.
Here comes a full court press, a 1-2-2. They're going to trap the ball immediately in the corners.
Chatard breaks the press. Cage tries to dump it in low to Coleman. Broken up. Back into the hands of Wade. And Wade connects for two. Jamal Wade with 3 points. Chatard on top by 13. In the corner, the two-point attempt missed. Right now, one shot and out for Elmhurst.
Going into the spread offense, or at least Coach Archer wants them to if they hurt him, with 38 seconds to go, why not? You're up 13 points, chance to go up 15 or 16 points. at least you're ahead 13 when the horn blows at halftime. So I think it's a great coaching move right there.
Under 20 seconds.
They'll come back, I think, to number 44 before it's over with Dan Page. I'm surprised that that was taken with 14 seconds to go.
Maybe not the shot exactly that they wanted. Elmhurst with an opportunity here. Poindexter's three is good. Joe Poindexter, his second triple.
That's why you don't shoot so early down here.
That's a huge possession for Elmhurst. Going into the locker room, trailing by 10, but a bit of momentum. 38-28. And Bob Nagel on the sidelines with Keith Edmonds. Robert?
Coach, big basket at the end of the first half. You're a little frustrated by the execution, but your kids are playing hard for you.
Yeah, they're working hard. I think that there's just the vastness and the nervousness of being in this game is what is hurting us right now. But I think once we get our legs up under us, we'll be okay.
11 fouls called in the first 4.5 minutes of the game, and now it's 16 at halftime. Everybody kind of settled down a little bit, didn't it?
Yeah, I think we just needed to relax a little bit and start playing our ball, and hopefully we'll be okay.
Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Keith Edmonds, the head coach of Fort Wayne Elmhurst. Take a break, and we're going to send it back courtside. Craig and Dave.
All right, Bobby. Chatard on top by 10, 38-28 here at halftime. Our halftime entertainment lying straight ahead. Don't go away. You're watching the 3A Championships live from Indianapolis.
On the floor here at Conseco Fieldhouse as they're honoring all of the Mental Attitude Award winners throughout the year in the different sports. It's always such a big part of the basketball boys state finals, the Chester Award winners, and of course we had the award winners for Mental Attitude in women's basketball 3 weeks ago. And the wonderful folks from Farm Bureau Insurance are sponsoring this presentation. They will give out over $38,000 worth of scholarships throughout the season for the IHSAA. They've been great partners with the IHSAA. And again, as a proud corporate partner of the IHSAA, Farm Bureau Insurance awards a $1,000 scholarship to each school attended by a Mental Attitude Award winner. This year, Farm Bureau Insurance will reward $38,000 to Indiana high schools through this program. And congratulating the winners at center court is Jerry Canada, Chief Executive Officer from Farm Bureau Insurance, Pam Walker, Special Markets Coordinator from Farm Bureau Insurance, and Blake Rest, the IHSAA Commissioner. We can tell you that they are honoring tonight. In football, Brett Butel from Southridge High School, accepting for Marcus Heminger is his brother Justin from Fort Wayne Snyder High School. Accepting for Mike Dury is his uncle Rob Doyle from Indianapolis Chatard. Rob, of course, representing Michael, who's in the locker room after having had a pretty good first half here in the 3A state championship game. In golf, they're honoring Sally Shonk from Noblesville High School. In cross country, Neff Araya of Lawrence North High School. In swimming, Katie Robinson and Ted Brown. Katie's from South Dearborn and Ted Brown from Western. In soccer, Kent Melchior's from Evansville Memorial High School is being honored here tonight. Also want to congratulate Andy Skillman from Jasper High School. In girls basketball, Annie Morgan is here from North Vermillion. Amanda Norris from Shenandoah. And Katie Gerald from Beach Grove High School is here. In volleyball, I want to congratulate Christy McConnell from Wapahani High School, Charlie Day from Providence High School, and in gymnastics, Lauren West from Chesterton High School. Those are among the award winners who are present with us tonight, helping make this a very special night. And we've already handed out scholarships to two Chester Award winners here today, two more coming up in the 3A and 4A championship games. We've got a dandy going here at halftime. Indianapolis Chatard is leading Fort Wayne Elmhurst by 10 points. We'll take a break, and when we come back, we'll give you the answer to our Watson's trivia question and bring you up to date on more of what's coming up in tonight's broadcast of the 4A state championship. That'll feature Indianapolis Pike against DeKalb. And boy, what a day it's been already, and we're looking forward to more. And we congratulate again all the award winners and the folks from Farm Bureau, a great partner with the IHSAA, giving out the scholarships here tonight. We'll take a break and be back in a moment. You're watching the state championships on the LaCie Broadcasting Network. Basketball yet to come tonight, including our second half. The answer to our Watson's trivia question, who won the first state championship? Well, no, it wasn't Noblesville with Dave Nicholson. It was actually Crawfordsville in 1911 who won the first state championship.
Got a break. Be back in a moment with the second half of our 3A state championship game on the LaCie Broadcasting Network.
Pounds with Dan Archer, pretty good first half, Coach. I know you don't want to make any major adjustments, but another tough half against Elmhurst.
Yeah, well, that was not a good ending to have him hit a three, but overall we're pretty pleased with the way we played, but it's only one half.
Good luck to you in the second half.
Thank you.
All right, Coach Archer wants to get back to his team, and second half ready to get underway. Let's go to our team, Craig Wallen and Dave Nicholson.
And Dave Nicholson with some highlights, Bobby. And Dave, it sounds like a broken record, but we did have some great plays there in the first half from this game as well.
Well, we had some great plays on both sides, and there you saw one of them by James Hardy, number 34, on a nice jump shot, and a long ranger by Joe Poindexter for a three-point shot. For Chatard, Dan Cage, their outstanding player, for a power play inside, and you're going to see the quarterback, left-hander Mike Drury, hit a left-handed three-point shot. The halftime highlights.
Plenty of highlights here and much more to come. We're at halftime, 38-28. Chatard with a 10-point lead. We mentioned at the outset, neither of these two teams had ever played at this level in a state finals game before. So something's got to give here, Dave.
Well, you have to feel good, I think, if you're Chatard, but that last shot might give Elmhurst a little momentum.
Our halftime stats brought to you by Arturo's Italian Restaurant. Arturo's is Howard Kelman's favorite Italian restaurant in Indy.
Look at that next to last stat on rebound.
Yeah.
22 for Chatard, only 11 for Elmhurst. The shooting is a little better by Chatard, but the big difference has been in rebounds. Turnovers, 5 Elmhurst, 6 Chatard. Almost even except for the boards. We said the physical strength of Chatard could be a factor. It definitely was in the first half.
Hardy inbounds for the Trojans of Elmhurst. He had 7 first half points, 8 for Poindexter, and a quick turnover gives the ball back to Chatard.
Again, Poindexter was a little shaky there, let the ball slip through his hands, and Chatard once again pounces on it.
Chatard, 21 wins, 2 losses on the season.
I would be surprised Chatard doesn't go back inside. They'll find Cage down in there, Baker.
A little short. Dury stays with it, though. Misses on the follow. Elmhurst with a ball. This is Edmonds. Across the lane and fouled. Chad Edmonds.
From facial expressions, I believe they're going to call that on Mike Drury, number 33 for Chatard. I'm wrong. It's on number 24, Ryan Baker. And you know, Elmhurst has had 2 possessions, and they really need to make one of these to kind of give them a start here in the third quarter. They had the big 3 to end the first half. This might get them going in the second half and cut into that 10-point deficit.
Baker committing his 3rd as the first free throw is made by Chad Edmonds.
Here comes a replay on it. Edmonds does a crossover dribble, splits the defense well, takes it right at Ryan Baker and drew the foul. That was a good move and a good call.
Edmonds, 2 of 3 from the charity stripe here today. Consecutive free throws. Chatard by 8. Full court pressure.
That press by Elmhurst, and they backed it up a little bit. They were trapping immediately in the backcourt. Now they're wanting to trap about along the 10-second line.
Presser. Bounce pass. Off the wing. Wade shot. Good. 2-pointer. No, 3-pointer, they say. Jamal Wade with 3-point jump shot. On the other end. Short there. Chatard comes down with it. Baker going up high for the rebound.
If you're Chatard, you move it, get the shot you want. You're not the team behind. That's the one you want.
Baker on both ends of the floor working hard. What a great pass to him.
Well, they know their strength. You saw Brewer go inside. He didn't finish a minute ago. And that time you saw Baker finish. They know they're stronger inside, and they can finish if they get the ball in the position down on the block.
Britton Flowers penetrates, bounces right into Baker. Another turnover. 43-30, Chatard by 13. And a slow start for Elmhurst to begin the second half.
Too many turnovers.
Yep.
They're not taking care of the basketball.
Open, Wade. Again.
Well, I don't know how many times you let him hit that before you get out and contest, get a hand up, and I think Coach Edmonds thinks the same thing as he calls a timeout.
Jamel Wade, 38% from outside that three-point arc during the season. So he's got some efficiency out there. And boy, Chatard jumping all over Elmhurst to begin the second half. 46-30. And I want to ask you, do you own a Hewlett-Packard or a Lexmark printer? How about a Okidata color printer? For whatever printer you own, you need to know about Canon 4. When it comes to printers, printer service, and computer supplies, Canon 4 has the solution. Canon 4, your printer, printer service, and computer supply source. Canon 4, serving Fort Wayne and Central Indiana. Visit them at www.canon4.com.
Here's a replay on that Jamal Wade three-pointer. Remember, that's not a rerun. He just made one about 30 seconds ago. That's his second one from almost the identical same spot.
Yeah, it looked like a replay, didn't it? Inside 6 minutes to play in the third period.
Now that timeout, Chatard comes out in that 1-3-1 half-court trap. They're wanting to end this game. They're really wanting to put the pressure on and create a 20-25-point lead.
What a block there. Cage way up there to bat it out of bounds.
Not a bad move by Coach to change up a defense after a timeout. It's a surprise element. Usually a trap is not something you stay in for an extended period of time. It has a lot of surprise element in it anyway. But coming out of a timeout, throw him something different.
Hardy misses on the side. Chatard has it back. 16-point lead, 10-point margin at halftime. Elmhurst has scored just 2 points here in the second half so far. Across the lane, Presley gets it to bounce around and drops through.
Five touches on the rim before it dropped three. You know things are going well when that type of thing.
And Marcus Presley with his first points, averaging 5-3 per game during the season. And a foul on the other end.
Quick penetration there, and I believe that's on Ryan Baker, and I have him for three personals, Craig. And of course, is that four?
Yeah, that's four.
That's really an important factor, I think, and it might open the door for Elmhurst to get back in this game because it's obvious how important Baker is, not only scoring, and I have him for 12 points, but on the boards and defensively.
And Baker, a quick exit following the fourth personal. Poindexter on the miss. Rebound to Dan Cage. Quickly ahead, open man there, and Presley finishes nicely. Marcus Presley, a couple of quick baskets.
A little sleeper. He leaked out on the shot and released. Got an easy layup.
Driver, who I believe hit his very first shot after coming in off the bench earlier. A couple of misses here. And misses on that attempt.
You're seeing now what a team can do when you've got a nice, comfortable 18-20-point lead. You can release, take chances on that. You can shoot the passing lanes a little bit. And plus, you can take all the time you want to get your shot because time is of essence for Elmhurst.
Pull-up jump shot, perfect for Hardy. The three-pointer right on the money for James Hardy. Nice job, Chatard, handling the pressure well. The miss shot by Dan Cage. Here comes Hardy. The pull-up jumper on the way hits the front rim. Backboard. A little bump there, nothing called.
You don't want to change the rhythm of your team, but I know right now the coach wants that kind of shot.
Dury, that's that high percentage shot that we saw so much of in the first half.
You don't want to go up and hurry things, and you don't want to get in foul trouble.
And a steal. Wade missed. And it's out of bounds. It belongs to Chatard. Bishop Chatard really putting the pressure on Elmhurst right now. Timeout on the floor. Back in a moment. You're watching the 3A state finals from Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. There are power, there is power in the numbers, and Dave, lots of interesting stats here so far.
Well, you look at the key one, it's still rebounding. Chatard 28 to only 15 for Fort Wayne, almost double rebounding. When you do that, you're going to be in trouble, and I really think Elmhurst has to make an inroad into this margin in the next 3 minutes and 40 seconds. If you go down 19 going into the fourth quarter, you're in big time trouble.
I agree totally. Boy, what a power outage for Elmhurst. They've scored only 5 points so far here in the period. The rebound, though, down to Poindexter. Tries to maneuver his way across that free throw line, and he's fouled at about that point by Wade. Jamel Wade picking up the personal.
Yeah, good stutter dribble there by Poindexter, and he was able to split the defender and to draw the foul. That's four fouls on Chatard here in his third quarter and zero for Elmhurst, so that plays in Elmhurst's favor too. If they can get into the bonus, make a few free throws without time going off the clock, that's the best way to cut into a large deficit.
Poindexter reverses.
He's quick with that spin dribble. Poindexter.
Yes, he is. Hardy gives it up. The steal. The other direction. And a travel.
Yeah, that's a good call. Couldn't quite get his feet set. He knew he was open. He knew he couldn't go all the way to the basket. He would risk getting a charge called and scooted his feet.
Presley, though, with some good defense to create that steal. The pull-up jump shot by Hardy, not there. And a little tug on the jersey.
We saw it. Britton Flowers couldn't catch up with him. He said, I'm not going to let you get that loose ball. And he reached out and pulled on the shirt. The official was not in a position to see it.
I think Wade.
We'll see if this shows on a replay.
Wade was amused by this.
Watch this. Oh, everybody in the world saw it except the official. And you're right. Wade had a little bit of a smile on his face. But you can do that when you're ahead by 19.
That happens once in a while. It's not always caught, though. Poindexter in the miss. Back on the other end. Chatard. Left-hand shot by Dury. No good. Loose. And a whistle and a foul.
I'll tell you what Dan Archer's thinking over there, coach of Chatard. He's not going to say anything because he has confidence in his kids shooting. But he'd just soon they pass that ball three or four times rather than take that shot that Dury just put up. Sure. That was off one pass. He was defended pretty well. And yes, Mike Dury can hit that shot, but does he need to take it at this time? No. With 2:37 to go and leading by 19 here in the third quarter.
And that isn't the first time, Dave, that we've seen a little bit of anxiousness creep into a game when a team's had a lead here today.
I mentioned earlier, you don't want to break the rhythm of a team, but.
Oh, that's going to be three attempts from the free throw line. So not a real good foul by Presley.
Yeah, Marcus Presley ran out at the shooter, and that's another thing that just gives you ulcers if you're a coach. You've got a nice lead. Don't foul the three-point shooter. And you'd have to give Flowers credit for a little that. He did a nice job of taking the hit and going down. He didn't get hit much. I think the breeze of Presley running past him knocked him down.
And well, those perimeter shooters, they do take acting courses. I know that for a fact. But that was a foul.
But you just don't want to foul the jump shooter, period. And you definitely don't want to foul some guy taking a three-point shot when you're ahead by 19.
Flowers, you'll get one more. TGI Fridays downtown, located at 501 West Washington Street across from Victory Field. TGI Fridays serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week, starting at 6 a.m. One more on the way for Flowers, and he connects. Elmhurst with some full court pressure. And a good job by Chatard, although the travel will give it back to Elmhurst.
Yeah, you saw Mike Drury there going a little bit too quick, and he stuttered step. And I think you're going to see Coach Archer in a minute come out with those palms down, which means settle down, slow down a little bit. Let's get what we want. We've got all the time in the world.
Driver. Hardy kicks it out. Poindexter can't get it to drop. Nice effort and a save by Driver. Flowers. The three attempt is no good.
Well, the error once again did not hurt Chatard because Elmhurst was not able to take advantage of the situation. And Chatard turns it over yet one more time. And you see who's pounding the ball on the floor?
Yep.
The guy right there, Dan Archer. He says, I think I can dribble this thing and take care of it. Yeah, if you guys can.
You'd probably be doing the same thing if you were out there today.
One of the nicest guys that coaches in Indiana right there, Dan Archer. What a great guy. He was a longtime assistant at North Central with Doug Mitchell. Still very, very close friends with Doug.
Poindexter the miss. Chatard with the ball, the commanding lead, and a whistle and a timeout on the floor. We'll keep it right here, and want to remind you that we've got a big 4A contest lying straight ahead, so don't go away. DeKalb and Pike coming up in our fourth and final game of the day here from Conseco Fieldhouse. Been a good day.
Been a great day for high school basketball or basketball fans in general. And there you're looking at the 4A matchup to follow this game and about as soon as the award ceremony is over. No secret what Dan Archer wanted to say. You know, he says, guys, we're ahead 17. We're playing like we're down 17. Come up and take care of the basketball. Let's get the shot we want. Let us attack the basket. Let's go back inside where we've had all kinds of success and settle down just a little bit. And I bet they do that.
.133 left to go here in the period. I tell you what, they keep pushing the ball, that's for sure, with that lead. Chatard putting pressure on Elmhurst.
Well, that time it was part of the press breaker, and they had a two-on-one situation, and Elmhurst just made a great defensive play and saved a layup. Nothing wrong with attacking the press, but the decision-making comes about the foul line. If you don't have an opportunity to shoot an open jump shot or get your teammate a layup, pull it back. You've got the press one, so let's come back and get into our offense.
And a five-second violation against Chatard.
The errors are all of a sudden really mounting up on Chatard. They played such an almost error-free game up until about 3 minutes ago. Now they have become almost an automatic turnover.
You lose a little focus maybe when you've got that big lead. As we see the turnover, the ball going back to Chatard.
But you know what? Elmhurst has not capitalized. And when you're trying to come back from a huge deficit, and it sets at 17 right now, you've got to take advantage of the turnovers and everything. Miss free throw, whatever your opponent gives you. Fort Wayne has not made a two-point field goal this entire quarter.
That is huge with 1:14 left to go.
They only have 1-3, and they have made four free throws. They've only put up 2 for 7 points.
We said earlier, 10-point game at halftime, so Chatard has really stepped up the pace here, especially defensively in the third period. Gage hands off, a little bump from behind Presley on the miss. Surprised there wasn't a whistle there. Elmhurst into the corner, driver shot off the mark. The putback by Hardy is good. James Hardy with his first 2-point field goal here in the second half. 52-37 Chatard. On the other end, Cage denied. Wow, big time block in there by Stuckey. That was huge.
I know it's not their normal philosophy, but I almost think if I'm Dan Archer, I hold the ball for one shot. You're still going to have a nice lead, 15 points going into the, now it's going to be 17 going into the quarter, but I'm not sure you want to give Elmhurst much momentum.
Trey Mason's first points of the night. 25 seconds left to go here in the period. Flowers kicks it out. Poindexter loose there. Hardy pulls up. The jump shot on the way. It's no good. And the rebound down to Chatard and a jump ball called. Chatard's ball with 12.7 left in the period.
Just enough time if you get it up, make a couple of passes, take the last shot of the quarter, and you lead by 17. So obviously it's a great situation for Chatard. Elmhurst will try to trap as soon as the ball comes on court. We mentioned earlier, sometimes they trap immediately, sometimes they back it off to the 10-second line. They're lined up now, like they're going to put extreme heat on the pressure. Try the fly out.
Pearson into the ball game, comes up with the ball. 8 seconds.
Elmhurst.
Yep, they've got a chance here. This is Poindexter. Misses the putback attempt. No call. Boy, did Poindexter get up there. And Coach Edmonds is hot.
He thought on that last play, and I'd have to see it again, but it looked like the shooter's arm went down. He definitely thought his, and you're going to see it here, folks. Take a look. Here's what the coach is upset about. He goes under. Oh, he was across his arm, and that looked like Dan Cage was all over the shooter's arm.
And that would have been some free throws, definitely, for Elmhurst. Hey, we've got one period left. Back in a moment from Conseco Fieldhouse, the 3A state finals. On the sidelines, Robert.
We talked about the family from Chatard. The family's here from Fort Wayne Elmhurst. Keith Edmonds' sister is here. Mom and dad are seated behind me here. But the rest of the family's on the bench. He's got his uncle, His brother and his brother-in-law joining him on this table. Still got some hope? You ready to go fourth quarter?
Oh, we're always ready to play ball.
Mom's back there. She's praying. You still, Mom?
Whatever happens, I am proud of our boys. We have gotten this far, and it hasn't been easy. I am really proud of them.
Good for you. That's the way it should be. Let's go back to Craig and Dave.
Chatard up by 17, but the big three cuts it down to 14.
Joe Poindexter stepped up and busted the three. And in that third quarter, it looked like Elmhurst was making a move, but actually Chatard.
Baker picks up the loose ball. Dury had some problems with it.
Chatard outscored Elmhurst 16-9 in that third quarter, even though Chatard had an extremely long drive spell.
Poindexter, Dury with the rebound.
We'll see what kind of shots the Chatard Trojans take this quarter. I think they'll be high percentage. You saw Baker get that layup last time. No reason to force the outside stuff. Move the ball, keep the clock running. And about 3 minutes from now, you can start a smile.
So you think Dan Archer has gotten that message to his players, huh?
I think there's no question. Some question where Baker should be back in the ball game there, and you saw what happened. Flowers fouled the shooter being Marcus Presley. He'll go to the line shoot two, but when you've got the nice comfortable lead, you can do anything you want. So he decided to bring Baker back in, and it's already paid off in one field goal.
Flowers with the personal foul. His
There's
second
the foul going, excuse me, Marcus Presley going across.
Yeah, I think that might be the first foul, isn't it, in the second half for Elmhurst?
You're exactly right. They only have one, and Chatard has 16 fouls. That is one way that Elmhurst can cut into the lead. They may need to attack the basket, which they've been doing the last 3 minutes pretty well, get to the free throw line. I don't think if they rely on shooting the outside shot and keep the clock running, they've got enough time to get all the way back. But certainly if they can get four, five, six free throws mixed in there, there's plenty of time to get back in the ballgame.
A couple of misses by Presley. Three-point shooting very big all day long, and right now Elmhurst with the slight advantage, although they've taken a whole lot more shots.
Man, they've shot 22, but they've only made five.
But good shooting teams sometimes go through that drought, don't they? They just need to keep shooting.
Yeah, they're 66% as a team on the year.
There's another three-point attempt. John Locke with the miss. Chatard with the ball, 6:10 left to go in the 3A state finals from Indianapolis. The three for Dan Cage. Perfect. Cage with his second triple here tonight. He's got 15.
Cage is their money man, and he's got confidence to take it anytime.
Poindexter with the miss. Baker with those four fouls, playing big on the boards. And that one counts. Well, that is a football team on the basketball court, literally speaking.
Well, you and I talked at the lead-in how physical Chatard is, and it's showing. The physical strength has just been the difference in this ballgame.
Well, you don't need to coach much of that, do you? Dury with a power move to the basket, and he'll come to the free throw line following the timeout. We'll be back in a moment. Chatard on top by 21 in the 3A state finals on the LaCie Broadcasting Network. Methodist Sports Medicine scoreboard, and Trojans all over there, but what we're looking at is Chatard's 61-40 lead. The Chatard Trojans on top.
And not only that, it hasn't been one or two guys. Dan Cage has 15 points, Drury 13, Baker 12, Wade 9, and Coleman 6. And they're setting on the biggest lead of the night, 21-point spread, as you mentioned. Points in the paint. We talked about the strength difference down low. Chatard had scored 32 times in the paint. Fort Wayne's only had 10 points down low. You know, I mentioned earlier, Craig, that Dan Archer really started building this team 2 years ago. He's kept them together. Last year, they thought they would make a run. They got upset by Lebanon in the Shelbyville Regional in overtime. So they made a total commitment at that time to get right back where they are today and to get to the state finals and go for a state championship. You have to do that.
Sounds very similar to Basil Malby's situation, where he came up short last year and the guys just focused on getting here this year, and they did it. And Chatard back in it and looking pretty good right now. Now Gage, his long range three is no good. Baker, the strong rebound and put back.
That's been the story all day. If they miss the first attempt, teammate steps up, goes physically to the bank boards and gets him another attempt.
Glenn Dexter, it looked like he may have traveled. Doesn't matter though. To the other end. Too strong by Cage. The putback though is good and he's stuck with it.
If first you don't succeed, try again. And young people forget that sometimes. Some kids hang their head when they miss a layup or make a little mistake. If you're a good player, you just keep going.
Flowers the miss by Stuckey. And Hardy with the putback.
Some people might wonder who in the world beat Chatard this year. Well, they got beat by two very strong 4A teams, Perry Meridian and Cathedral, both excellent 4A teams. So they didn't get beat by any soft teams.
And certainly those losses make you just a little bit stronger. When you're playing those 4A teams, it's bound to make you stronger. Presley drives. Poindexter the rebound.
You know, a lot of people still talking about class basketball. This is the sixth year for it, but it would be kind of nice to see Chatard go against the best 4A teams in the state. And who knows? I think they could compete very well.
I think you're right, Dave. As well as they're playing right now, they may be playing their best basketball of the season. You'd know better than anyone.
I think there's no question they are playing their best basketball. And as a coach, that's all you can ask for. When you're in the state tournament, you're playing your best basketball.
And there's a whistle out top. Do you own a Hewlett Packard or a Lexmark printer? How about an Oki Data color printer? Whatever printer you own, you need to know about Canon 4. When it comes to printers, printer service, and computer supplies, Canon 4 has the solution. Canon 4, your printer service, and computer supply source. Canon 4, serving Fort Wayne in Central Indiana. Visit us at www.canon4.com. 65-42, Chatard. Inside 4 minutes to play. A slowdown game by Chatard.
Yeah, you can't blame them. They've got the ball game under control. Why risk anything? Just finish the clock off.
This Ryan Baker with four fouls has been extremely effective. He had a long sit on the bench, but coming back, he's just all over the place.
He's put up 6 points since he re-entered the ball game.
And he gets a little fancy there. Maybe you heard us talking about him, huh?
Coach Archer, Dan Archer, just stares up at the lights. But, you know, he can smile about it when you're ahead 25 points. And I'll tell you this, if the game had been on the line, Dan Cage would not have thrown it behind the back pass. But you're allowed a few privileges when you lead by 25 with 3 minutes to go.
I agree. Driver shot. And a foul on the... That's our Trojan.
Dan Cage, I believe, according to his reaction. And no use to get excited now, son. You're about to pick up a state championship trophy.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's give credit to Fort Wayne Elmhurst. No one expected them to be here. Gary Roosevelt was the team that everyone thought would come out of the northwest corner of the state. Elmhurst beat them last week. They deserve to be here. They've had a great year. They're going to leave here tonight with 22 wins and only 6 losses. Outstanding season. And again, Coach Edmonds and his entire team should be very proud.
Hardy at the free throw line. And he can't get it to drop. Dury comes up with it. Inside 3 minutes now. Clock counting, 2:53 left to go. And a pick the other direction. Driver pulls up, jump shot, nope. And it's out of bounds. It belongs to Chatard. Lots of people to thank here tonight. Not the least of which is Jerry Baker of the IHSAA, Mark Higdon of Associated Sports, and the fine folks at Conseco Fieldhouse. Jamie Burns, Eric Nelson, Susan Skelton, thank you for your support.
Dan Archer got off the bench and he was talking to his star player, Dan Cage, and he said, just take care of the ball and pass the ball. Let's get this game over with so we can celebrate. And I suggest in about a minute or less, we'll see the bench clear.
Basket counts. Dury with another two-pointer. Racking up the points, and you'll go to the line.
Dan Cage on the ball game. 17 points, 9 rebounds, 8 assists. What a great effort for a state championship any game, but particularly when you do it when you're playing for the state championship.
Those are solid numbers. And a substitution.
Tony Barnes, 6'5 senior, number 50, comes into the ball game, and you'll see the subs trickle in frequently in the next minute.
Baker with a whale of a game. He just played tremendous defense and offense out there. Drury with the free throw. To the other end we go. Edmonds the miss. The putback is good by Stuckey.
50, Brandon Stuckey.
70-44, Chatard. And the left-handed lean-in shot is good by Dury.
Well, he's left-handed, and that was a perfect thing. He was on the left side of the basket. The pass led him perfectly, and he just put it softly off the glass.
Oh, they're having fun now out there. Wade, the beneficiary of some good defense. Jamel Wade makes it a 74-44, 30-point lead for Chatard. It was a 10-point margin at halftime. The second half has belonged totally to Bishop Chatard. Presley picks up the foul, his second. Hardy will go to the line.
Jimmy Scheidler coming in. He replaces Mike Drury. Mike Drury had an outstanding ball game tonight himself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2-point shots, 14 and 1-3. I have him for 17 points. Dan Cage is letting each of his seniors take a bow and each of his starters take a bow. You'll see Wade go out in a minute, and I'm sure he'll take Ryan Baker out last so he can have, I should say Dan Cage out last, so he can get his due recognition.
A lot of players receiving due recognition here today from Conseco Fieldhouse. The 3A state finals, 4A to come. Big matchup lying straight ahead. Don't go away. DeKalb and Pike. Inside. Barnes on the miss. Hardy. A long three attempt. And the long rebound. Comes out to Chatard. Barnes will go to the free throw line.
Well, you can hear the crowd react. They want the senior Tony Barnes to get in the scoring column. He almost did a minute ago. It rattled out. Now he's going to go and get himself two free throws.
Barnes at 6'5". You know, he's the kind of guy that makes the other guys as good as they are in practice.
That's a great point, because he probably has had to bang on with Cage and Drury and Baker all year long. And without someone working very hard against you, you simply do not get better. And I know the coaches appreciate players like that. Sometimes the fans don't understand why a senior would do that. But if a senior's got a chance to be a part of the kind of team that Chatard has, why wouldn't you want to be? That's my question.
There's some hugs on the side as Dan Cage retreats. 17 points, 9 rebounds, 10 assists, the double-double for the 6'5 senior, Dan Cage.
Doesn't get any better than that, as you see on the screen. You play your last high school game, you cut down the nets and walk away with the state championship trophy.
Well, Barnes with a couple of attempts to get on the scoreboard and couldn't quite do it. Elmhurst will have the ball back with 1:10 left to go. Chatard up by 30. In the corner, the three by Locke. Nope.
You know, Bob Negley talked to, I believe it was Coach Edmonds' mother there a while ago.
Yes,
and she said, we are really proud of the young men, no matter how the outcome tonight. They've been overachievers, and it wasn't easy to get here. And that's the attitude every fan should take today, win or lose. These kids come down here with one purpose. They lay everything on the line. They've worked extremely hard since the beginning of November. And every fan should support them totally and support the coach totally.
Great point. And you don't see a lot of frustration there in the eyes of Keith Edmonds. I'm sure there is pride welling up inside despite what's happened here tonight. This Bishop Chatard team playing excellent basketball, and Barnes has his point.
Gets his point, and you heard the ovation from the Chatard crowd.
That kind of made their night, didn't it? Players excited.
Well, when you have a young man that doesn't get too many minutes, they know how hard he's worked, and he has a lot of personal pride, and they're really pulling for him.
Two in a row. That's great to see. And Elmhurst
stepped out of bounds.
Yep, turns it over. Do you own a Hewlett Packard or Lexmark printer? How about that Okidata color printer? For whatever printer you own, you need to know about Canon 4. When it comes to printers, printer service, and computer supplies, Canon 4 has the solution. Canon 4, your printer, printer service, and computer supply source. Canon 4, serving Fort Wayne and Central Indiana. Visit them at www.canon4.com. And nothing is dropping for Fort Wayne Elmhurst right now. And the same can be said for Chatard. It's getting ugly. Barnes, he's got a field goal along with his two free throws. 4 points for the senior.
5 seconds.
The shot. No. The save. One last attempt and the basket no good. And that marks the end of our 3A final. And an exciting win for Indianapolis Bishop Chatard. They complete the season at 22-2, state champs of 3A. Look at the celebration.
Craig, you want to know what a state championship means? Take a look at that picture. Lots of hours put in by all the young men in that group, and you could say the same for the Fort Wayne Elmhurst team. They've worked very hard to get here, and again, they'll leave here with a real pride in what they've accomplished.
It is an exciting moment for this Dan Archer coached Chatard team, and not as exciting, but certainly a proud moment for Keith Edmonds. Let's go now to the floor and Bob Nagel. Robert?
Well, Dan Archer is a happy man and has been happy for quite a while. You guys came on the second half and you knew that first 4 or 5 minutes was going to be crucial.
Yeah, you know, and we had struggled sometimes during the year, but when you have four seniors on the floor and you've got kids with the heart our kids have, it's just an amazing team. I think it's one of the best kept secrets. Pike's had a great year, but I think we've got a hell of a ball club.
Well, and you got so many great leaders. Cage had a great game, and what can you say about your leader out there? He did a great job in the football season, did a great job here. Mike Dury just double-double for you.
Well, I think when we talked, I told you he does a lot of things. You know, he steps up when we need him, and that's what this team's done all year long. It's just amazing. Coleman today was huge in the second quarter, and Mason. And, you know, we're pretty deep, and, on down the line, Baker, Dan Cage, Jamal Wade, you know, they got the job done. It's just fantastic. Marcus Presley, too.
I know you had a lot of respect for Elmhurst coming in. It's one of the reasons you were so well prepared. You knew they could explode on you.
Yeah, and you know what? I was worried at the end of the half. You know, when I talked to you, that three-point shot, that was a big momentum changer. But our guys came out right away and got a quick turnover and got control of the game. And I think you're right. I think that kind of took a little bit of wind out of their sails.
Yeah, earlier this season, you had a loss to Cathedral. You just knocked him out of the record books, the biggest win in ever history in Class 3A. Congratulations.
Thank you. It's a great honor, but we're just glad to get the ring. Thank you.
Well, congratulations, Dan Archer. Still in control, and his kids did a great job for him. We're going to talk with some of his athletes in a moment. We've got another award being presented here, and let's go back over to Craig and Dave. And, boy, can you believe we get to do this one more time today?
Yes, it is a wonderful thing, Bob, to be talking to those players and coaches on the floor. And our announcement of the Arthur L. Trester Award, Mental Award winner, will be coming up here momentarily, so we'll keep it right here. It's an exciting award given annually to that Mental Award winner. And in A1A basketball, it was Derek Smith of Southwestern, and 2A Bauer earlier winning it. And we'll find out who gets that award here tonight. Following the big win, 78-44, Chatard over Elmhurst to Fort Wayne. The attendance in the first session, 13,036. And as big a crowd or bigger here tonight, I think, Dave.
I was talking to Associate Commissioner Ray Kraft, and he was hoping to get a total of 27,000, 28,000. I think they'll easily do that.
Mental Attitude Award for boys this Class 3A.
Here's the award announcement.
It's Michael Dury of Bishop Chatard.
Mike Dury, Bishop Chatard, the Trester Award winner for 2003 and 3A. Can you get a senior year, Dave, that's any better when you look at the accomplishments of this guy? The football field, basketball, his best sport, baseball yet to come.
He's a three sports guy. As you said, he quarterbacked the state champion in football, and he really kind of quarterbacked the state championship in basketball. And coming up, he'll be the baseball player in college, I understand. So what an athlete.
Going to be playing for Paul Menary at the University of Notre Dame. Dury, the Arthur Trester Medal Award winner.
And you need to remember, folks, that a major part of this award is not necessarily what he's accomplished athletically, but what he's done in the classroom and the kind of person he is. Each school can nominate one player for this award.
And our thanks to Farm Bureau Insurance, the IHSAA corporate partner, presenting that scholarship check for $1,000 to Indianapolis Bishop Chatard High School in the name of Michael Dury. Back in a moment, Chatard, the 3A champ. Basketball continues. Fieldhouse, where we've just completed the 3A championship game. Chatard, the winner over the Trojans of Fort Wayne Elmhurst. Back to the floor and Bob Nagel.
Well, thank you very much, partner. And we're here with the Dury family. We've done this before. You remember back at the RCA Dome when Chatard won the state championship. More history being made here today. And Michael Dury, congratulations. What a great year and a great day for you.
Thank you. It's just incredible. It's just great to be part of this community, the Bishop Chatard community, all the fans, my teammates, my coaches. I love them. Coach Archer did it. He did it. And it just really sums everything up. It's just touches my heart to get this award. It's great.
It's nice to have talent. It's nice to have coaching. It's very important to have a spiritual togetherness. You guys have been a very tight unit your entire senior year.
We have. We're best friends. We've gone through a lot, you know, a lot of adversity early on, freshman, sophomore year, and coming back. And Dan Cage led us, and Coach Archer. Coach Archer did everything. He stayed positive and got it done.
We're going to talk about you having a double-double, but you've got a double-double with the Mental Attitude Awards. That's the first time in history. What a great accomplishment.
Thank you very much. I know how much this award means, and I'm just greatly honored and gracious, and thank God for getting the award.
I know you wanted to give one to your dad and one to your mom, so you had to get two of them. Introduce your starting lineup here.
It's my mom, Nancy, and my dad, John.
You got to be very proud, John. I know this has been a very emotional run for you, and it's hard not to get emotional when you think of the accomplishments of this young man.
Well, thank you, and yes, it is emotional. It's very bittersweet because of Mike and Dan and Ryan have been playing together since fifth grade, and now the journey's so neat, and now it's the end, and that's the bitter part of it. But I mean, it's, how do you say bitter about this? But you know what I'm saying? It's been a great run for these kids. They're wonderful boys. We knew this was coming.
Some guys up in the stands thinking you're going to do this in baseball, too.
Well, we've got some tough teams to beat first before we do that. Let's just we'll enjoy this one for a night or two. So thank you, though. Thank you.
Mom's a lot of years of driving to practice, picking them up, buying shoes, doing laundry. It's always a special moment, but all worthwhile.
It is. It's been a lot of fun. And I tell you, you're only as good as your teammates. And he's been surrounded by wonderful teammates. His coaches are outstanding and great role models. And the whole community. I mean, our whole community has just been so this is wonderful. We're very, very fortunate to be a part of it. So
it's been very special, and we congratulate you again. And Michael, congratulations, partner.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Hey, Mike Dury, you'll remember that name for a long time. The only one to ever win a Mental Attitude Award in football and basketball. And like I say, baseball is still yet to come. He's an accomplished baseball player, as they know up at the University of Notre Dame, where he'll be playing next year. And Craig and I tell you, David, what a special young man. What a special moment out here.
Yeah, and Dave, you know what? I just really enjoy this part of the night because we get to see and hear the heart of these champions. And Dury is a champion in every sense of the word. Just look at what he's done, you know, off the floor as well as on the floor, so much. And what a gentleman out there.
Well, and that's the third Trester Award winner we've had today, Class A, 2A, now 3A. And what I really appreciate, one of the first things that comes out of those kids' mouth, we want to thank my teammates. Without them, yep, I wouldn't be here. And, you know, every team is about we and not me. And that might be the reason these teams are here today, because they do give of themselves first and worry
you know, worry about themselves second, put the team first. But that's one thing. And in every case, you can tell it's a close family atmosphere. And being in education for 32 years, if there's one key to a young person being positive and doing positive things, I think it's the home, mom and dad. And so everything you've heard today, I think, verifies it.
Boy, great point. University of Notre Dame bound on that baseball scholarship. Mike Dury, our medal award winner.
Win the Trester Award in football and basketball, but your best sport's baseball. That tells you what kind of athlete Mike Dury is.
Yeah, he takes it all in stride, doesn't he? So humble. Chatard, the big winner here in 3A, and their awards being presented right now at center court. Again, 78-44 the final, and boy, Dury did have that big game, well over a season average. And you know, Dan Archer talked about it. When we really need Dury, he said, he comes through.
Well, that's a sign of a good leader, and I had him unofficially for 17 points. And as you pointed out, he only averages 10 on the season. So you almost double up on your season average when you're playing for a state championship. That is really stepping up, as you pointed out.
More awards coming here, and our coverage of our post game will continue as well as we keep things right here. We feel like this is as important as what's just been seen in terms of the competition between the two teams. And we want to make sure that the families of these winners get to see their sons cross the stage. This is a very, very important part of what we do.
And if you're watching out there, folks, and you want to get a Coke or something, get ready, because we've got the 4A coming up. Pike High School coming in here undefeated. And of course, DeKalb, having lost only one game all year, they came back and defeated that team in a tournament trail. So it should be another great one coming up in just a few minutes.
It should be. And Chatard now joins the ranks of Lafayette Central Catholic, an earlier winner in 1A. The final there was 68-64, if you missed it. Lafayette Central Catholic over Southwestern. And then Cass in 2A completed an undefeated season. 26 wins, no losses for head coach Basil Mauby. Cass, a winner over Forest Park in that 2A final, 57-48. Dan Archer with his family. Great shots here from Conseco Fieldhouse.
I believe Dan Archer's first job was at Western Boone High School as an assistant. And you like to see people succeed that pay their dues. He went from there, as we documented early, to North Central and served several years as an assistant coach to Doug Mitchell out there. Then decided he was ready to put his own program together, went to Chatard. And frankly, Chatard had not been very good in basketball when he arrived. He has good players. He had good athletes. But a lot of schools sometimes have good athletes, and they don't come together with a state championship. So you have to give Coach Archer a lot of credit.
Yes, you do, and you bring up a good point. We've seen it earlier in the 1 and 2A games where coaches have paid their dues, as you say, Dave. They've hung with it many times as a freshman head coach, a JV coach for 10 or more years, just waiting for the opportunity to be a head coach on the varsity level in the state of Indiana. Bob Nagel with another interview on the floor. Robert?
Well, with Keith Edmonds, whose team showed a lot of class. This was tough tonight, Coach, but what a great year for you. You come down to the state championship game, a great accomplishment in itself. It'll feel better tomorrow, but you guys, you held your head up high tonight. Just came out here and gave them a battle.
Yeah, I mean, they just beat us inside. We knew that, I mean, really, that's been our Achilles heel all year. And we've just tried to cover up for it and compensate for it, and we just got caught tonight. They're a very good team, and obviously, they scouted us very well, and I knew we were kind of soft inside, and it just caught up with us tonight.
They did a pretty good job on the perimeter, kind of took your big guy away. He's an excellent player, great athlete, and he wasn't able to really get out the way you know he can.
Yeah, he just didn't have his A game tonight, and sometimes that happens. You never know what's going to happen in tournament play, and normally our other kids step up, and we just didn't have it tonight. We just got beat by a better team, and you know, there's really no excuses. We just got beat by a better team. Even if we would have played our A game, you know, we still might have got caught tonight.
We had a chance to talk to your mother during the game, and she said, I don't care what happens tonight. This is a great team that's had a great year, and she's very proud and said everybody should be very proud. I think she hit it right on the nail right on the head.
That's just a mom. I appreciate her support, and she's been with us every step of the way. When we came into this program 6 years ago, and we were 3-17, and to be at this point now says a lot about our kids and the support we've had.
It's always magic when you get down here. A lot of your kids will be back next year, be hungry to come back here and take that big prize away. We wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much.
Keith Edmonds, and as I said, his team has shown a lot of class here tonight in a situation that would have been tough, but you had to get out of the way of the express train from Chatard tonight. Dan Cage is going to join us here from Bishop Chatard. Dan, congratulations. Almost a triple-double here tonight. I know individual stats don't mean all that much to you, but you guys were getting it done. You wound up having a lot of fun out there.
Right. Tonight's the team stuff right now. I'm just so excited. It's a great night. You know, we didn't expect it to be like this, but it was just so much fun, and it was a great sending off for us seniors. Played with these guys 4 years, and it was just a great day.
When you buy into the coach and you buy into the program and what it's about, it feels so special, because that's really the difference sometimes between a team with good talent and a team that takes a championship.
Right, exactly. We feel like we're talented. We feel like we got some of the individual talent too, but you know, when we buy into what the coach says, we work well as a unit, as you know, a team together. So, I mean, that's what our motto all year was together, you know. So we're just so happy to do this. Everyone did their part. It was just a great day.
I want to bring Ryan Baker over here. Ryan is going to get a chance to he'll have the burden of repeating this thing. Ryan, you're the junior on this team, but what a special night for you.
It's a great night. We have great seniors. Dan Cage, Mike Dury, Jamal, Marcus. They just led us all the way here, and they're the best leaders we have.
It's been a very special year for Chatard, the state championship in football and now in basketball. And everybody say, well, we're going to be good in baseball too. But when you look at what you guys did tonight and accomplished against a pretty good team, a very athletic team, a team that likes to shoot on the perimeter, you not only got it done offensively inside, but you got it done defensively on the perimeter.
They had an awesome team. Their coach was great. James Hardy is an all-star. He could shoot the ball. They had Point Dexter. He was great. They're just a great team. They had a great game versus Gary. Props to them. They're a very good team.
There's going to be a new fundraiser at Chatard. They're going to have to build a wing to put more trophies in, build another trophy case. But that's okay with you guys, isn't it?
It's great. We got to come back for next year, Coach Dan Archer.
All righty. We're going to get some of your other teammates in here. These guys are sporting nets. I want to bring these guys over. Congratulations, state championship. How's that feeling so far?
It feels great. You know, we worked hard, and we didn't think we were going to beat them this bad, but we just play hard, come out to win. No.
Jamal Wade is with us, and Jamal, you guys fed the ball inside in the low post and got a lot of good results, a lot of assists from getting it to your big guys inside.
Well, that was our game plan. We knew that they weren't that good defensively. If we went inside to our big people, that we can get our offense started, and that's what we did.
You also got out on the perimeter. I thought your defense on James Hardy was exceptional. You didn't let him really get his game going and get a good night going. That was a big part of it.
Well, he's a very good player, and that was one of our keys, is to stop James Hardy. It's because he was a good scorer, and we just like wanted to stop him, because we knew if we stopped him, his team could get anything started.
Marcus Presley's alongside. Marcus, congratulations. You're state champion.
Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate this.
You're wearing a net down here at Conseco Fieldhouse. This is a dream of so many kids, and you get a chance to come down here. What a great group of seniors. An exceptional opportunity, wasn't it?
Yes, I mean, I love these guys, all five seniors, and I don't know where else I could be without just playing basketball with these guys.
Pretty good team came in here, very athletic team from Elmhurst, and you guys got out on them and you stayed on them. A lot of fouls early in the game, and then everybody settled down pretty well.
Yes, I mean, we knew they're athletic, but we've had a good, hard, tough road to come to this game, and we knew we could play with them.
You guys are leaving a great legacy for the guys that'll follow. They got to follow you guys. It's a tough act, but a great one. Congratulations on the state championship.
Thank you.
All right, Jamal, congratulations.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
All right, these guys are having a good time, and well, I tell you what, they talk about, you hear this at banquets when teams win championships. I love these guys. You got to buy in, and they did. Let's go back courtside to two guys that we love.
Oh, Bob, you're so special. The heart of a champion. We're hearing that from the floor of Conseco Fieldhouse. Everyone's a champion in our books. And Bishop Chatard, the winner here in 3A, back in a moment from Indianapolis. Pike and DeKalb, the 4A championship, lying straight ahead. Chatard, the winner in 3A, 78-44. And it's time now for the Reeves Buick Pontiac play of the game. Dave Nicholson.
Well, we talked about Dan Cage scoring. He also had 10 assists. And in this play of the game, you're going to see one of the best ones, as Dan Cage is going to get this rebound, and he's going to find Marcus Presley on the fly pattern. There it goes, and Presley, the beneficiary, scoops it up and puts it off the glass for 2 points.
Cage with some great strength there to get that chest pass down the floor the way he did, right into the hands of the open Presley. Outstanding play. Well, as we said, we've got the 4A game coming up, and we're going to kind of bring a close to this 3A telecast in just a moment when we return. Chatard, the winner here from Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis.